Hi guys, this is Blitz Gaming here, and today I will be showing you the new comp that arrived here, the Fortune of Desert Sands. So it's like the last comp, it's like a 1990, but this one is much better for a NPC target, which is a non-player castle. So actually, much better for Nomad and Samurai castles, or the events. So yeah, 1990 comp for that event is much better because I can have more loot and I will be attacking much more with this comp on them. So let's go over the stats and equipments here. The hero here, which is Sand Sorceress, she gives you like more of the combat strength for range and melee for NPC targets and some courtier bonus. So this is good comp for non-player castle like Robber Baron castles, Barbarian Fortress, then Sand and Desert Fortress, which are Dragon Fortress and that stuff, and also Nomad and Samurai. So yeah, that's the kind of NPC targets. So going over the helmet, it is Helmet of Desert Legend. This gives you travel speed, wall and mode protection. I never leveled up any of these pieces, so there are like the base levels, level 1, and I have like all the of the 9 pieces as I completed this. The gem here I attached is Explorer Stone. It looks like a good stone for courtier bonus and some gate protection. Gives you like more flank 2 for NPC targets. So as you can see, there's like more stuff for NPC targets than a normal castle. So it is much more effectful, or you can say much more powerful against NPC castle. The weapon here, the Scorpion Tail, is also travel gate and wall. The gem here attached is Legion Stone. It is giving you more courtier bonus and travel speed. And then that gives you more for courtier for just NPC, so you can know that more bonus here from gems and hero, and the other bonus for completing the set is all for NPC. So much better comp for NPC castle that is Nomad and Samurai. The armor here, Armor of Desert Legion, is giving you more of moat, wall and gate protection. You can see the gem here is same as the one in the helmet, but the name here, it is the Sorcerer's Stone. So gives you like same bonus for them, both of them, the helmet and the armor gem that I have, this one and then this one, both are same, and then these two are same. And the artifact here, the Lamp of Desert Sorceress, gives you more resource looted then mode and gate protection. So and the gem here gives you courtyard and gate protection, which was same as the one in the weapon. The gem here is Scorpion Stone. I do like the names for this commander's equipments and gems, but I don't like how the gems look because they are not like as much colorful as they as the other equipments are. So yeah, but it's much better comp for Nomad and Samurai. So let's look over the sets individually. So you have 1990 bonus and then 10% more bonus for NPC target, which makes it 100 and 100 over there. It has 20 normal courtier bonus and then 70 more for NPC target. So much more for NPC target, and then there is 76 wall plus 30 for NPC target, which makes it 106. Then the same for the gates, just it is 40 here, so it will make you 116. And then 54 moat is better. After leveling them up, I guess it will be around like the stats will be increased by like 15%, so I guess it will be 15 more, which is 91 enemy wall protection as normal, and then 91 plus 30 is 121 for NPC target, and then same for the gate thing. This is my guess actually, I don't know for sure because I never leveled this commander out. It's still a base level that is all PCs are one. And I will actually level them up very soon. So you have more soldier limit on flanks by 40 for NPC targets here. And then there is 52 travel speed, which is a good commander because you can hit more faster. And then 16 resource. So that's it. That will be the stats. So let's go and attack a rubber band castle with that commander. Here I have a level 14. Actually, I like all of them like around level 14 in my account. So we'll hit with the Fortune of Desert Sands comp. Using autofill is the only thing for me because I don't actually care about what happens. I just keep attacking them so that I can have more of them leveled up and like more getting more better equipments from them. So let me just fast forward this clip for a while until it gets attacked, and then I will be back. So it looks like it's almost there. Let's just wait for a few seconds and then we'll be done. I don't expect more loss from this attack because I actually used a 99 comp. So let's see the report. Here we killed all of them and we have no losses here. So as you can see, this is much better comp. And actually, I like this because I don't want to lose so many souls on this rubber band castles. Actually, I don't care because I don't have a lot of souls, but still, losing more of them is much worse than losing a few and performing events. So, this was the new comp, the Fortune of Desert Sands. So, as you might have seen, it's a much better comp for Nomad and Samurai, especially the NPC targets. And you can try to find them, you can try to get them, but you need to be at least level 50 to get them because they're not available for levels lower than that. So this was it. If you like the video, please like and subscribe the channel and share it if you want your friends to know about this. We'll get the other videos and stuff will be coming on in next week. So just stay tuned to this channel and try to watch every piece of them because this is all the guide for this game that is Good Game Empire. If you want to join, I am in currently in my ally, which is Invictus Legion. You can search for this or just search for my name here. And it will pop up and just message me. I will check you out and then I will let you in my alliance. So that's it. Stay tuned for more updates and see you all guys in the next video.